It's been a long time. I remember you as a student and me interviewing you at that time and you giving tips about clerkship. And now you're a seasoned PA. You've worked in three specialties. You're doing great work working with vulnerable populations in the Ottawa area. So, like, thinking about your journey so far, are you happy with your decision to become a PA?
Yeah, I'm very happy. You know, I don't regret applying to the program or becoming a PA at all. I don't really see myself working in any other profession. People always ask, you know, like, why didn't you go to be a doctor? Or, like, why didn't you choose to go into nursing? Or why didn't you do this? Why didn't you do that? I think it all depends on, you know, what pathway you chose to begin with. You know, I chose health sciences. I knew there was a need to, you know, increase access to care. And I met this fantastic PA who, you know, made me fall in love with the program. So it's very fulfilling work to do. The fact that we're still a new profession is also really important to me as well, too, to be able to kind of help be the trailblazers that make the profession into something a bit larger. The PA profession itself has grown quite quickly in the past couple of years, especially more so than a lot of other professions who've tried to take the same route as well, too. You know, we've only been around since about 2007, 2008, when the programs became initiated with the pilot projects. In a short period of time, we heard this year that, you know, we're going to be regulated, which is a very short time frame for a new healthcare profession to be regulated in total. It's really nice to see that you're working in an area where it's growing and you're helping it grow.
What impact has having a PA had for the services that you've worked with?
I haven't been in a single position where, you know, adding a PA wasn't beneficial to help. The big part that I like about being a PA is that we're a constant for the patients. We are someone who's generally available for them to talk to, even if the physician's not available to do it, or, you know, even if their specialist consultant hasn't seen them yet, we're always able to be there as their kind of first point of contact, right? So we're someone with a bit more of specialized training that can help them and improve that way.
Do you have any tips for physicians that are thinking about hiring a PA, but they're not quite sure if it's the right decision for them?
There's a lot of physicians that are very on board for hiring a PA, but there's a lot of barriers that we experience as well, too, that mostly being funding, right? So if you're a physician group who missed the application for the Career Start grant, or you're really not certain about how you're going to pay for this profession to join your group, it's important to, you know what resources are out there for you. One being our association. We have a lot of good information online that helps people or physicians know, you know, what entails hiring a PA. There's a specific section that specifically goes through, you know, PA information for employers and, you know, what things you have to consider when employing the PA. There's a lot of different ways that we can be funded. My specific position now is actually funded through the government. We're funded through Health Canada through an application for a program. So that's one way that individuals can fund PA positions. Another way is through fee-for-service, through shadow billing. So a lot of physicians are, you know, a bit hesitant, saying that, you know, if I hire this physician, what if we don't make enough to cover the costs? And it really depends on how well they're looking to utilize the position as well, too. If you really utilize your PA and you're able to, you know, run a clinic more efficiently with more patients, I found that in my experience, for example, like the profession essentially becomes, if not cost neutral, then at least a little bit profitable as well. You might have to get creative in finding different fundings from different places, whether it's through a specific program through the government, through fee for service, or through, you know, foundations through the hospital. PAs are funded through many, many different ways, but don't be hesitant to reach out, right? Reach out to their association if you're looking to hire a PA. Reach out to another clinician that you know that has hired a PA and can give you more information about, you know, what their worries were and how they overcame them. Or, you know, put out a posting, such as what my employer did. And once you have PAs coming in, ask them how they would see the position working in their company to see what you can do.
For those that are thinking about becoming a PA, but not sure if it's the right route for them, I think having to decide what you're going to do the rest of your life is a very intimidating decision to make. So what advice would you have for people that are thinking about becoming a PA?
Just make sure you look into the profession enough before you start applying. There's lots of resources we have for pre-PAs to access. Resources that, you know, are new but are quite large. One actually being, you know, different Facebook groups that are out there, like the Pre-PA Student Network, where you can connect with PAs as well as other students who are applying to bounce off questions. There's lots of things going on right now in terms of Instagram and Zoom meetings where you can do virtual shadowing sessions with PAs through the Education Council and things like that. So there's a lot of different areas that you can access this information, and even if you're wondering, you know, this isn't enough, I need to ask more specific questions, try reaching out to a PA online, right? If we have all these PAs that are in these groups or PAs that are on Instagram, who are more than happy to, you know, answer people's questions if they send them a message or something like that. So just make sure to use your resources and don't be afraid to jump in once you fall in love with it.
For sure. And if people have questions for you, what's the best way to get in touch or to follow you online?
So people have reached out through a bunch of different ways, mostly through Instagram or through Facebook, through Facebook Messenger or something like that. I kind of get a bit of both. So physician employers and different groups will reach out to me by email just through connections. And then other PAs or PA students will reach out to me through social media. And I do have a Instagram account that I do a little bit of PA work on. And then through the Canadian Pre-PA Student Network as well too, I answer questions through there.
Well, thank you so much. That was actually so enlightening. I feel like I learned so much about the work that PAs can do to make an impact for vulnerable populations, specifically working with homeless, addictions, mental health, and providing primary care as well. Any final words?
You know, don't be hesitant to reach out or to put questions out there. The communities that we built online, especially on Facebook, are very supportive. So no one's going to judge you for asking questions. So go ahead and post.